弟兄姊妹平安。
Brothers and sisters, peace to you.
今天是第73天。
Today's our 73rd day.
我们会谈到基督里面的代罪。
Today we're going to talk about Christ's atonement.
赎罪。
The atonement.
代罪。这是重罪之身，这个是我们的题目。
It's the sin bearer.
所以在罗马里。地方他是用十字架来杀他的仇犯。
In the Roman culture, they use the cross, the crucifixion, to punish their criminals.
有千千万万的人死在十字架上。
There are tens of thousands of people that died by crucifixion.
但只有一个，就是主耶稣，是我们所历史里面所记得，特别记得。
But it's our Lord Jesus that's specially recorded.
对于比拉多来说。他要杀主耶稣，因为他要平息这个民众 的愤怒。
To Pilate, he agreed to crucify Jesus to appease the crowd.
对于犹太人来说
，To the Jews,
他们认为如果主耶稣继续这样讲下去
，If Jesus continues,
罗马政府就会加给我们很大的压力。
Then the Roman will oppress us even more.
但对于基督徒来说，主耶稣的受死是我们的。Atonement, 我们的救赎。
But to Christians, the death of Jesus is our atonement.
所以今天我们会，特别留意着这个救赎的对象。
So today we're especially going to focus on the salvation,
the focus of this atonement.
The atonement.
所以我们从另外一个不同的角度来讲。
So we're going to speak about it from another angle.
首先我们要谈到这个救赎。究竟主要是什么一回事
？So we need to understand what is this redemption, this atonement. 啊，
所以在马太福音二十七章。
So in Matthew chapter 27,
四十五节。
Verse 45.
从午振到深初，遍地都黑暗了。
From noon until 3 in the afternoon, darkness covered all over the land.
Yeah, 这个是三个小时。
This is 3 hours.
遍地都黑暗
all darkness covered all over the land.
因为在深处，耶稣大声喊着说
About 3 in the afternoon, Jesus cried out,
以利以利拉玛撒巴各大利，就是说我的神我的神为什么离弃我
He cried out in a loud voice, Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani, which mean, my God, why have you forsaken me?
这个也是主耶稣临死之前的最后的一句说话
This is also the last word that Lord Jesus said before he died.
当然他死的时候说成了。
Of course, when he died, he said, this is complete.
在这个十字架上有七句说话是主耶稣讲。
While he was on the cross, he said 7 words.
是十架七言是非常出名的。
It's the 7 words on the cross.
但是最出名的或者最重要的就是这一句说话。
But the most important statement he made was this statement.
神啊神啊为什么离弃我
my God, why have you forsaken me?
这个说话是从诗篇二十二篇里面直接拿出来的。
This is referenced directly from Psalms 22.
是非常重要的说话。
It's a very important statement.
这句说话就清楚地表明究竟什么是救赎。
This statement clearly describes what is salvation.
你知道在这个生命记里面呢有一大段的讲到你犯这些这些这些罪就被咒诅
You know, in the book of Deuteronomy, it lists out all kinds of curses and blessings. If you do this and this, you will be cursed.
Yeah, 你这样子这样子行你就被祝福
And if you do this, this and this, you'll be blessed.
这个就是 Deuteronomy prophecy. 整个祝福和咒诅分开两边是吧
It will list out all the blessings and all the curses in Deuteronomy.
然后主耶稣在十字架上因为他担当了我们的罪
And when the Lord Jesus was on the cross, he carried our sins.
这个咒诅的终极是什么
What is the central point of this curse?
就是被神废弃
It's to be forsaken by God.
什么是地狱
What is hell?
你去地狱就是一个被神违弃的地方
If you go to hell, it is a place where God has forsaken you.
没有神的爱的
There's no love of God there.
没有神的怜悯的
There's no mercy of God.
没有神的光啊
There's no light of God.
只有黑暗
Only darkness.
只有痛苦
Only pain.
为什么
Why?
因为这个是咒诅的中心点
Because this is the central core part of a curse.
咒诅的中心点就是被神离弃
The core of curse is to be forsaken by God.
你知道 什么是祝福啊？
What is blessing?
我们谈过有一天谈过什么是祝福。
And one day we'll speak about what is blessing.
所以你们听过道的人，你就很清楚了。
So those who have been following our sermon, you know.
什么是祝福？
What is blessing?
哦，是我神祝福我发财。
God gives me well.
神祝福我有好的婚姻。
God gives me a good marriage.
很的健康。
A good health.
不是这样子解释。
It's not just this.
祝福就是神的面光光照我们。
Blessing is being under the light of God's face.
在犹太的祝福观念里面。
In the perspective of the Jews.
这个面光呢，会叫我们能够看见神的荣耀。
The radiance of God's face will cause us to see His glory.
如果神掩面不看我们的时候，
If God turns away and not show His face to us,
我们就看不见什么荣耀。
Then we don't see any glory.
我们只看见黑暗，这是邪恶。
We only see darkness and which is evil.
所以祝福是个非常非常光的一个图画。
So a blessing is a very bright picture that we see.
是他的面光光照我们。
It's the light of a face that shines on us.
是他的面光不断的引领我们走正路。
It's the light of his face that leads us continuously.
是他的面光保守我们平安。
It's the light of his face that protects us and gives us peace.
是他的面光成全我们。
It's the light of his face that fulfills us.
就在他的面光里面，我们有属天的平安与喜乐。
So under the light of his face, we have heavenly peace.
所以我们可以很简单说什么是祝福。
So simply put, we can say what is a blessing.
祝福就在神的面光之中。
Blessing is to live under the light of His face.
当神用面光光照你的时候，
and when He shines His light on you,
就是他的怜悯临到你，
it's His mercy upon you.
他的恩典临到你，
His grace is on you.
他的爱临到你，
His love is on you.
如果他的面一向你一转面，
if He turns His face,
你被离弃了，
you've been forsaken.
这个差不多是等于地狱，
and this is equivalent to hell.
完全没有希望。
Completely hopeless.
完全受咒诅。
Completely under a curse.
That is the fullness of the wrath of God. 是神丰富的愤怒。
The fullness of the wrath of God.
咒诅。
Curse.
很可怕的一个字。
It's a very scary word.
不是人咒诅你那么简单。
It's not as simple as a man cursing you.
中国人有时候打小人。
And sometimes in Chinese culture, they have these little voodoo dolls.
Yeah. 因为有些小人在咒骂你。
Because there's some people that scold you.
是吗？如果魔鬼咒诅你，
but if Satan curses you,
魔鬼会的最高高手来咒诅你，
and he's like one of high power and he curses you,
也不一样，不一样，
and that's different, right?
但是如果上帝咒诅你，
but if God himself curses you,
这个咒诅是远超过一切一切的可怕的事。
This curse is so overwhelmingly scary above every other curses.
所以主耶稣在十字架上，
so Jesus on the cross,
他最明显的代表。
The most obvious representation is,
就是这一句说话，
is this statement.
神啊神啊我的神为什么离弃。
My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?
他说两次，两次我的神我的神，两次表示很亲密的关系。
He said twice, my God, my God, representing that he was very intimate with God.
虽然他被神咒诅，
even though he was cursed by God,
但是神不是他的敌人。
But God is not his enemy.
所以他说我的神我的神。
So he said, my God, my God.
主耶稣在十字架上最痛苦的，
When Jesus was on the cross, the most painful moment,
不是他手上的钉痕，
was not his nails on his hand,
不是他那个头上的那个荆棘冠冕，
and it's not even the crown of thorns on his head,
不是他背上的鞭伤，
it's not the scourges that he bore,
不是他腿上的钉痕，
it's not the nails pierced on his legs.
我知道很多传道人讲这个主耶稣的受死呢，都很强调这些痛苦。
I know that many preachers, when they preach on the crucifixion of Christ, they will emphasize on these wounds.
其实这些痛苦代表不了咒诅。
But these physical wounds cannot represent the full curse.
肉体的痛苦永远代表不了咒诅。
The physical suffering and pain can never represent the curse.
真正最大最可怕的咒诅。
The biggest and most scariest curse.
就是主耶稣所讲这句话。
It's what the Lord Jesus said here.
我的神啊，你离弃我。
My God, my God, why have you forsaken me?
有些人说主耶稣其实神没有真正的掩面不看他。
And some people said that God really did not really forsake Jesus.
但是严格的神学实在是离弃了他。
But specifically, theologically speaking, he did forsake Jesus.
神不，主耶稣不单止被神离弃，不是感觉到被神离弃。
Not only did Jesus feel forsaken,
他是真实的被神 离弃。
He was actually forsaken by God.
所以一开始的时候，正从伸出遍地的黑暗。
So that's why in the beginning chapter it started with the whole darkness was filling the land.
犹太地那个时候的中午的很光很烈。
At that time when the Israel lands, it was noonday. It was really bright.
And hot. 是吧 ？Hot. 当时呢，那个时候好像神那种。关了他的灯一样。
But it's like God shut off the lights.
遍地的黑暗。
The entire land was filled with darkness.
就是这个咒诅，就是这个神的面光与神的掩面那个对照。
It's the mirror reflection of God's light face shining, and then His face was turning away.
所以主耶稣受了我们的咒诅。
So Jesus bore the curse for us.
所以我们看加拉太书第三章，保罗这里讲的是最。清楚的一句说啊。
We will also see what Apostle Paul said in Galatians chapter
3. 第一节他说，无知的加拉太人啊，耶稣基督钉十字架已经活化在你们眼前，谁又迷惑了你们呢？
In verse 1 it says, you foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? You clearly seen that the Lord Jesus was crucified.
就是这些加拉太人真的看过知道主耶稣的死。
It's that they, he was speaking like,People of Galatia saw clearly that Jesus was crucified.
但是好像他对这个主耶稣的死不太清楚明白。
But somehow it's like they don't really understand the death of Jesus.
所以慢慢的，他们好像是又一无所又好像被迷惑的，就好像不太了解这个事情。这个是保罗骂他们。
So slowly they were sort of led astray, confused, and was like they were bewitched. So Paul was scolding them.
所以十三节讲到一句说话，我们一定要记住这说话。
So in verse 13, we have to remember the statement.
耶稣既为我们受，原文成了咒诅，就赎出我们脱离律法的咒诅，因为经上记着，凡挂在木头上的都是被咒诅。
Christ redeemed us from the curse of the law by becoming a curse for us. For it is written, cursed is everyone who was hung on a pole, or original text tree.
基督不单是满足神这个公义的咒诅。
Not only did Christ fulfill the requirements of righteousness,
or satisfy, Christ becomes the curse. 他成了那一个咒诅。
But Christ became the curse.
所以你们要看见那个亚伦举起那个十字架是吧？这个木头上面看这个铜蛇是吧
？So when Aaron raised the staff and you saw the bronze snake wrapped around it,
所有被蛇咬的一看啊就好了。
Everyone who was bitten by the snake, when they looked upon that staff, they were healed.
所以今天的 medical field 医院呢，他们就用这个章。
So in medical fields, you see the emblem of this staff and the bronze snake. Very meaningful.
基督成了哪一条被咒诅的蛇
？So it represents that Christ became that cursed snake.
或者更讲得更精准一点，基督成了这个咒诅，咒诅的本质。
Accurately state, Christ became the curse itself.
所以，我们看见就是基督的死了，我们可以可能明天我们继续谈到整个的情形。
And so when we speak about Christ's death tomorrow, maybe we'll go in more depth of this whole scenery.
但是如果我们用这个被咒诅这个点呢，来看圣经的时候
，But if we see this curse and this atonement, this perspective, and then read the Bible,
我们有很多圣经的看法不一样。
We will see many verses in a different light.
我们先看约翰一书第三章第三章。
And we will see John,
First John
3.
第四节。
Verse 4。
约翰一书第三章第四节。
First John 3:4。
凡犯罪的，就是违背律法；违背律法，就是罪。
Everyone who sins breaks the law. In fact, sin is lawlessness.
你们知道主曾显现。
But you know that he appeared.
是要除掉。人的罪
，so that he might take away our sins。
但他并没有罪，凡住在他里面的就不犯罪，凡犯罪的也未曾看见他，也未曾认识他。
And in him is no sin. No one who lives in him keeps on sinning. No one who continues to sin or either seen him。
这里第五节说了，主耶稣的来到世界，主的显现是为了什么
？And in verse 5, What is the reason that Christ came to earth?
是为了除掉人的罪。
Is to take away man's sin.
Atonement. That's an atonement. 这个就是 atonement 的那个代罪救赎的那个定义。
And this is the definition of atonement.
除掉你的罪。
To take away your sin.
怎么除掉你的罪啊？
How did he take away your sin?
基督挂在木头上。
To be hung on the tree.
自己成了咒诅。
To become the curse itself.
代替了我们所有人犯罪的人。
To bear all the sins of mankind.
是吧？所以我们知道改革宗呢是我们很多神学都按照改革宗。
So we know that our theology is based on a lot of it is based on Reformed theology.
Yeah, 我们的特别我们的解经学是按照改革宗那个严谨的解经方法。
Especially the way we interpret the Bible is based on the hermeneutics.
但是改革宗本身呢，他们有一个叫做去镜像的 theory， 我认为他们没有按照改革宗的神学来解释这段圣经。
But in Reformed theology, there's something called the tulip theory, and I don't think it's strictly that Reformed.
Because they are not interpreting the Bible according to their own hermeneutic. 为什么呢？因为改革宗里面这样说。
Why? Because this is what the Reformed says.
就是神在创世以前。
That before God created the world.
他预定了一些人得救。
He predestined a certain people to be saved.
也预定很多人灭亡。
And then.Predestined a certain amount of people to be into hell.
对啊，然后他来的时候呢，他是为单独为这些得救的人死。
And so when Christ came to die, he would only die for this group of people that he predestined.
他也只单单是背负着这一群人的罪，没有背负全人类的罪。
And he only bore on the sins of this group of people, not the entire sin of the mankind.
当然，我们知道神有预定的能力。
Of course, we know that God does predestine.
待会我们谈到他的预定与预知，预知。
And then we spoke about his predestination.
是超越时空的。
It extends over time and space.
他没有可能预定的时候不预知，也没有可能预知的时候不预定。
He cannot know foresee and predestine, but predestine not foresee.
因为他是超越时空的。
Because he transcends time and space.
所以就算我们说改革中说神的预定。It's not based on the foresee, 不是按照他的预知。
So Reform says God's predestination is not based on what he foresee for new.
这句说话，我觉得你真的没有足够的圣经来做这个平衡。
But this statement, I feel, is not really based on a good biblical knowledge and theology.
对，我们不知道神按照什么来预定。
Right, we know that.
God, we don't know what God is predestined. What God based on to predestine. 这个是我们了解。他是按照他至高的主权，我们没有疑问。
Based on his utmost sovereignty, we don't question him.
但是神的预定，他预定的时候已经预知。
But when he predestined, we know that he already foreknew and foresaw.
是吗？
Right.
所以你怎么预定说他预定是没有理由？你怎么知道他的预定跟他的预知没有关系呢？
So how do you know that his foreseeing and his predestination is unrelated?
我们待会再谈一谈我。现在我们看一件事，就是这里说主成显现是要除掉人的罪。
But continuing on here, we know that Christ appeared so that he would take away our sins.
其实所有的圣经谈到赎罪的时候呢，都指向着世人。
We know that the entire Bible, whenever they mention atonement, they are referring to the entire mankind.
没有指着他教会。
It never just says his church.
这就是第一个。
And that's the first one.
我们看。约翰福音三章十六节，出名圣经。
And then we'll see the most famous verse, John 3:16.
Yeah, 神爱世人，甚至将他的独生子赐给他们。
For God so loved the world, he gave his one and only son.
这个是什么？赎罪。
What is it? It's atonement.
神的爱。
God's love.
对着世人。
Towards mankind.
是什么？是把自己的独生子赐给他。这个是讲到主耶稣的 atonement。
Is what that he gave his only son, and what is this pointing to? Atonement.
什么是把他的儿子给你的？
What is giving his own son to you?
就是他的儿子成了你的 atonement, 代替你的罪。
That his son became your atonement, he took your place.
本来神要打你，但是现在他打他的儿子没有打你，因为他代替你的受刑罚。
At first, God Father had to punish you, but now he doesn't punish you because his son took your place.
主啊，叫一切信他的。不至灭亡，反倒永生。
So that whoever believes in him will not perish, but has eternal life.
这个是什么
？What is
atonement?
Atonement.
Another spirit of atonement. Okay, 所以，因为神差他的儿子降世，不要定世人的罪， 乃是要叫世人因他得救。
For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world.
信他的人不被定罪。不信的人罪已经定了，因为他们不信神独生子的名。
Whoever believes in him is not condemned, but whoever does not believe stands condemned and already because they have not believed in the name of God's son.
所以这里讲到，为什么有些人下地狱呢
？So here, why do some people go to hell?
灭亡呢？因为他们不信神儿子的名。
Why do they perish? Because they do not believe in the name of God.
如果按照 reform 这个改革中的精神
，So based on the reform theology,
如果主耶稣都没有下来为有些人死
，If Christ came not to die for everybody,
他只为着他的教会死
，He only came to die for his church.
神的救赎基本上都没给任何其他人，只给他的教会。
Then his salvation is not really truly for all mankind; it's only for his church.
他也没有背负所有人的罪，只背负着教会的罪。
He also did not bear all sins of all mankind, but just the sins of his church.
这样子，你教解些不信神的人可以相信什么呢
？Then you ask the non-believers, what can they believe in?
神基本上没有把他的儿子给灭亡人。
Basically, God did not give his son to the ones who he predestined to perish.
主耶稣没有为他们死。
That Christ did not really die for them.
基本上，这主耶稣在挂在木头上的时候，他成为教会的咒诅，不是世人的咒诅。
Basically, when he was hanging on the cross, he was only becoming the curse for his church and not for all of mankind.
所以，约翰一书四章九到十节。
So in 1 John chapter 4 verse 9.
神差他的独生子到世界来，使我们藉着他得生。神爱我们的信在他此咒显明了。
This is how God showed his love among us, that he sent his one and only son into the world, that we might live through him. This is love.
这个在改革中里面呢，他们就说到，这里所讲的是一个拣选的爱。
In Reformed theology, here they claim that this is only a specific kind of love towards God's choosing.
Yeah. 但是呢，对于世界上人呢，只是是普遍的爱。
But to the rest of mankind, it's a universal type of love.
就是给你太阳，给你月，给你雨水。
A universal love, like giving you the sun, the rain, the wind, the earth.
那这句说话很，如果这样子解释，很牵强的。
But if you interpret it that way, it doesn't really make sense.
实在不是我们爱神，乃是神爱我。
It's that it says not that we loved God first, but that He loved us.
差他的儿子为我们的罪做了免回祭。
And sent his son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins.
这就是爱。
This is love.
首先，就是不是我们能够懂得爱神，乃是神先爱我。
First, it's not that we know how to love God, but that God first loved us.
第二件事很重要。
The second thing, very important.
什么是爱？
What is love?
Tell me what is love. 这里所讲的，我们整个圣经所讲的，新约里面所讲的爱。
The entire New Testament, when we talk about love,
就约翰三章十六节就说，是神爱世人，把他的儿子给他们，这个爱。
John 3:16 it says, "For God so loved the world, that kind of love."
这里呢，约翰一书四章九节呢，这什么是爱呢？差他的儿子为我们的罪做了免回祭。
And again, in 1 John chapter 4, what is love? Love is Him sending His only Son to be an atoning sacrifice.
所以这句经文跟约翰福音三章十六节是对照的，是吗
？So it's a mirror, it's a reflection. It goes parallel with John 3:16.
如果你硬要好像改革中要解释到，其实神只爱他所拣选的人，其他人都没有这个爱。
And if you follow Reformed theology, it's saying that God only loved His church and died for His church only.
我觉得你需要很多圣经才可以证明。
Then I think you need way more Bible verses to prove that point.
因为我们看圣经里面的 hermeneutic 里面的那个解经学里面，第一条最重要的就是 literal。
Because when we look at hermeneutics and interpret the Bible, the first point is most important is the literal meaning。
最重要就是这个作者呢，他写信的时候呢，他是希望传达他的心意。
And so when we see the author writing, we know that the author wants to give his literal meaning first。
他不是要写一个神秘小说，叫你看不懂。
It's not that he wants to write a mystery book and to confuse you。
所以你说神要表明他的心意。
So you said that God wants to express His heart.
他其实可以非常清楚讲，因为这个是整本新约里面最重要的救赎经文。
That God actually wants to clearly say because this is the most important verses.
我觉得按照改革中的思想
，I think that if we based on Reformed theology.
神应该讲一讲。
God should say this.
才清楚。
Then it'll be clear.
那听都系，他会说，神爱他所拣选的人。
Then it should be really like this: that God loved His chosen people.
甚至将他独生子赐给他所拣选的人。
So that He gave His only begotten Son to the one He chose.
叫一切相信他的拣选的人。
That
被拣选信他的人。
That whoever is chosen to believe in Him.
不至灭亡。反得永生
will not perish and have eternal life.
接下面说，被他拣选的人就不被定罪了。
And then the ones that he chosen, they will not be condemned.
不被他拣选的人罪已经定了。
And the ones he did not choose, they are already condemned.
因为他们不信神独生儿子的名，并且也无从可信。
And because they did not believe in the only begotten Son, and they also were not chosen to believe.
是吧？为什么神不讲一讲？
Why did not God say this?
是吧？结局也是。
And the second verse is the same thing.
如果这个爱，如果其实我们讲的是那个 atonement， 如果这个救赎是单为着他所拣选的人
，If atonement and salvation is only for His chosen people，
那么全福音的时候呢，有很多人听呢是没有用的。
Then many people who listen to gospel is meaningless to them.
不单是没有用
，Not only is meaningless，
全的时候是一个谎话。
The what we preach is a lie.
举例子。
For example,
你们通通的没有信耶稣。
Let's say that all of you do not believe in Christ.
这个是布道会。
And this is an evangelism conference.
但是里面当中有些是神所拣选的人。
And then, but amongst you is some of you who are chosen by God.
但有些是不是神拣选的。
But some are not chosen by God.
我就这么讲了，神爱世人。
So I'll preach like this: God loves the world.
是每一个呢，为你们每一个人使命。
That died for each one of you.
所以你们。信他的就得救。
So if you believe in him, you'll be saved.
不信他的就灭亡。
If you don't believe in him, you will perish.
This will be a big lie. 如果按照改革中的精神。
If based on Reformed theology, this will be a big lie.
你们当中坐着所有不是被神所拣选的。
Every one of you who sits here are not, if you're not chosen by God.
我姐去说话就是大话。
What I say to you is a lie.
对于被神所拣选的人。
But to those who God has chosen,
是真话。
What I say to you is the truth.
对不被拣选的人，
to the ones who are not chosen,
基本上 you can't even apply.
It's not applicable to you.
基本上你不可以信。
Basically, you cannot even believe.
没有机会信。
You don't have the opportunity to believe.
因为主耶稣基本上没有为你死。
Because basically, Christ didn't die for you.
也没有为你赎罪。
He also did not atone for you.
你要信什么？
What do you believe in then?
所以我应该怎么讲呢？
Then I should say this.
其实改革中人应该讲你全道。
Actually, the reform should preach the gospel like this.
如果他们不讲你全道，他们其实是虚妄的。
If they don't preach gospel like this, basically they are lying.
因为他们的真话不敢讲。
Because the truth they do not dare to say.
他们只讲一个漂亮的话。
They just want to have a beautiful lie.
改革中人应该讲一讲。
This is what the reform should say.
但这里当中有些人是被神拣选。
Among here, there are some people who are chosen by God.
我不知道是谁。
I don't know who it is.
但神爱你们。
But God loves you.
今天你要信他就不会灭亡。
Today, if you believe in him, you will not perish.
但是有些不是神所拣选的。
But some of you who are not chosen by God.
这句说话完全与你们无关。
Is completely meaningless to you.
因为主耶稣没有为你死。
Because Christ did not actually die for you.
所以我知道改革中里面所有的原理，我一直在研究。
I know that there are many principles in Reformed theology that I have studied.
所以他们研究的那个 limited atonement 里面有很多很多的东西，我们可以将来可能慢慢谈。
And so there are many things about the limited atonement part of the tulip theory that we will speak about later.
所以我们现在最后到罗马书第八章。
So at the end here, we want to go to Romans.
这是因为他预先所知道的人，就预先定下效法他儿子的模样，即二十九节。
Chapter 8, verse 29. For those God foreknew, He also predestined to be conformed to the image of His Son.
三十节，预先所定下的人，又照他们来，所照来的又称他们为义，所称为义的人又叫他们得荣耀。
Verse 30. And those He predestined, He also called; and those He called, He justified; and those He justified, He also glorified.
所以改革众人说。
And so reforms us.
神预计一切，一切。
That God foreknew everything.
但是他就按照他最高的主权，又就是。就是要预定一些人得救。
But based on his ultimate sovereignty, he will predestine some.
我觉得应该是这样的解释。
I basically think they should say this.
This is a brand new theory.
This is a brand new theory.
That is probably called HGC theory. 留神听这个 theory.
Carefully listen.
就是 神在创造世界以前，羔羊已经为我们死了。没有创造世界，羔羊已经被杀了。
Before God created heaven and earth, the lamb was already slain.
是啊，希伯来是说到神创造的工程，但第六天已经完了，所以他进入他的安息。
In Hebrews, it says that God's creation was completed in 6 days, and the seventh day He entered into rest.
这里的说法，因为上帝是没有时间观念的，没有时间的限制的。
It's because God's not limited by time and space.
所以我们有人说，因为他预知到我们会信他，所以他预定我们。这个时候是阿门念说的，这个也不对。
And the Armenians would say that He predestined because He foreknew, and that's also not right.
他知道有些人不信他，所以他的预定你不得救。
And He foreknew that some will not believe and some will believe, so that's why He predestined.
但是其实呢，这一切神在创世世界以前
，But actually, before He created,
羔羊已经被杀了。
The lamb was already slain.
这个救赎的大爱已经为着他的人类。
The love of redemption was already poured out for mankind.
他的预知历史之间，因为他创造的时候已经立刻预知。谁会信他？谁会不信他
？And he foreknew all the history that was about to take place.
所以他拣选了一些人，他拣选我们 call 的余文余民的 remnant.
So he chose some people, remnant.
然后又叫他们那个称义，叫他们称义。
And so he justified those.
也叫他们的荣耀。
And he also glorified those.
但是你不可以反过来说。
But you can't flip it around and say.
哦，神呢一早开始呢就定一些人得救，定一些人下地狱。
That he predestined some to be saved and some to perish.
所以他的羔羊被杀呢，就是为了被拣选。
So that the when the lamb was slain, it was only to his chosen.
所以他钉十字架的时候，那个不是背着世人的罪，乃是背着他教会的罪。
And so that when he was on the cross, it wasn't for all mankind, but only his church.
这是我们的 theory.
This is our theory.
25年之后呢，就会。世界就会慢慢的研究。
In 25 years, we know that everyone else will try to study this.
We'll start to study it. Yeah, 我有25年去预备我的书。
I have 25 years to prepare my book to prove this.
Yeah, 所以神会给我活到85年命。
So God will let me live for another 85
years. Very healthy, just like now.
Very healthy, just like now.
因为他知道在哪一个的。这个再一次的 讲到这个 theory 的时候，是非常重要的时刻。
Because when we form this theory again, it's a very important moment.
通常人你活了一生，你到顶峰点了，你已经老了。
Most people when they live and they reach their peak, they're already old.
哦，所以我现在讲一句说话，你们尝试着了解。
I'm about to say a statement. Pay attention closely.
什么是系统神学？Systematic theology.
What is systematic theology?
就是它有好像一个树叶，它有一个干。
It's like a leaves off of a branch.
Yeah. 然后所有的经文呢，都好像这个主干呢上发散出去。
And it's all these verses from the branch spreading forth out.
所以改革中的 systematic theology， 改革中的那个神学。
So a reformed systematic theology.
它中间几条。树叶的主干就是神的主权。
The main branch of the theology is God's sovereignty.
所以他从这个主权里面看，所有的经文都是指说，哦，他所预定的，他所预定的，他所预定的。
So from this main branch, all the leaflets that extends from it, they're going to be based on God's sovereignty.
普通的浸信会啊，很多姐姐叫他们呢，就不是改革中的，非改革中的。
And the other denominations like the Baptists, they're not like the Reformed.
他们采取的。叫做 gospel systematic theology， 这是他们中间几条线是 gospel 福音。
And their gospel systematic theology is their main branch is based on the gospel。
所有的经文都指着福音。
And all the verses, all the leaflets is based on the gospel。
是吧？这是两个基督教里面最大的系统神学系统。
And this is Christianity's two main systematic theology。
啊，当然还有小群的，就是整个中间线都是指着教会。
Of course, there's smaller groups, and then the branch is based on the church.
什么都是指着教会。
Everything is pointing to the church.
那个小群不是 smaller group, it's a very, very big denomination. 小群 is like the brothers, the brothers.
The
弟兄会啊 ，Leaders and Watchmen Lee.
That denomination.
That denomination. Right. So there are a lot of few smaller systematic theology group. Okay.
Yes.
但是我认为。
But nevertheless, I think.
圣经整本圣经是神告诉我们终极的是什么
The entire Bible is telling us
What is the ultimate point? 不是神是主权我们不是要神是最高主权
The ultimate point isn't that God is sovereign
没人 会怀疑这个东西
No one will doubt that
整本圣经要高举的是神的爱
The ultimate point that's lifted up is God's love
整本圣经所高举的是神的救赎对着全人类的堕落的救赎
The ultimate point of the entire Bible is the atonement, the redemption of mankind
这个救赎就在主耶稣钉十字架那一刻成了 the climax of the entire Bible
And the climax of this redemption is Christ on the cross which is the climax of the Bible
我们如果有一条如果有个 systematic theology 中心点
If we have a systematic theology and our main branch is
这个中心点一定是按照神的爱
Our main branch is based on the love of God
并且基督的救赎
And Christ's redemption
并且福音的大能
And the power of the gospel
这样是神学才平衡的
Then the theology is balanced.
所以这一条线的神学，二十五年就出牢了。
So this main branch of this theology, 25 years later, it will come out.
It'll come out. You can mark my word on this. 好，感谢主。
Okay, praise God.
我们今天谈到基督的死。
Today we talk about the death of Christ.
我们。最能够叫我们感觉的是什么
？What is the thing that most that impacts us the most？
不是神的主权。
It's not God's sovereignty。
不是他多么的有能力。
It's not how powerful he is。
乃是他的爱是多么的长阔高深。
But how great and grand is his love？
如果你要 limit， 要说他的爱只是为着教会，为着他所拣选的一小小人。
If you have to limit his love by saying that he only died for his chosen church,
这样子, I think you missed the point.
Then you missed the point.
You missed the whole glory of heaven. 整个天下的所显明的就是主怎么爱我们。
The entire universe, what it's manifesting is how Christ loves us.
父怎么爱我们。
And how the Father loves us.
赐他独生子给我们。
To give his only begotten son.
叫我们只是这个无罪的成为罪代替了我
To cause a sinless to become a sin and take our place
基督是多么的爱我们
How much does Christ love us
他在十字架上的时候
That when he's on the cross
他背负着全人类的罪
He bore the sin of mankind
所以上帝离弃了他
So God the Father forsaken him
这个是终极的咒诅
This is the core of the curse
他被挂在木头上为我们担当
That he hung on a tree and became the curse
叫一切信他的
So that all who believes in him
不至灭亡
Will not perish
反得永生
But have everlasting life
Not just for the elected But all who believes 让我低头祷告
Let us pray
圣诞主耶稣，我们在这里没有心谈很多神学。
Dear Lord Jesus, we don't speak in depth of theology.
因为我们的心不是在神学。
Because our heart is not on theology.
但是神学太重要。
But theology is so important.
叫我们讲的道不会离开你的真理。
To cause our messages not to leave from your word.
但是主啊，求你叫我们能够碰见的是你的爱。
But Lord, cause us to encounter your love.
叫我们碰见的不单纯是神学。
Cause us not to just encounter theology.
主啊，在你的大爱面前。
Lord, before your great love.
我们只能够低头敬拜。
The only thing we can do is to bow down in worship.
我们基本上都不敢说。
We cannot say.
主啊，你只为着我们教会而舍命。
That you only died for your elected church.
求你帮助我们。
Lord, help us.
祷告是奉主耶稣基督的名求。
And we pray this in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.